All right, welcome out, ladies and gentlemen, to West Lawrence High School out at the baseball field in the dugout with our favorite baseball coach, Brian Brown. And Brian, it's so good to be here with you again.
I look forward to it every week.
Baseball is going well at West Lawrence. The diamond is shining out here.
Sure
everywhere
is.
We go, seems like the team does well by and large.
Yes, sir.
I want to back up about three games because it's been a few games since we last spoke, and you were headed up to Baldwin a couple weeks ago.
That's right. That was Friday.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, yeah. And that turned out to be a pretty good game. Matter of fact,
a
short game, wasn't it?
It was. We ended up defeating Baldwin 14-0, and we hit the ball hard that day.
Mm-hmm.
We really did. Baldwin struggled a little bit pitching-wise and walked some hitters, but our guys did a good job of moving guys up and, knocking them in when they got in scoring position.
Yeah.
I was real proud of them.
Yeah, it was a real good game. And being part of that spring break, it gave them time, gave everybody time, maybe some more fans to get up there. And, you got to enjoy that week a lot. Got to cap it off on a real good note there.
We did.
Yeah.
We did.
Anytime you hit the ball like that, like you say, it's fun.
It was real good.
Makes it a lot more fun. All right, well, who was your shining star, so to speak, on that? Who would be your most valuable player, outstanding player?
That game was Jared O'Neill.
Yeah.
Man, he has been on fire lately. He's been shining. And everybody else has caught that fire. I mean, it's just ignited into everybody else. And I've been very fortunate to be a part of it. And just hope he keeps rolling. Mm-hmm. I think he had 2 or 3 RBIs that game and several stolen bases. And he's creeping up on that stolen base record.
It's 33, 36, what was it?
30 is the record.
Okay.
And right now he is 22-23.
Ooh, all right.
So he got 4 more last night. So.
But 4 in 1 night.
4 in 1 night.
Boy, he keeps that up. He will break it.
He will. And one thing that I looked at today, I went back and looked at our record book for high school.
Mm-hmm.
The record for stolen bases for a team was 109 back in 1997. Right now, we are 90 for 109.
Ooh.
That's how many stolen bases. No, 102. We've only been thrown out 12 times.
Okay.
12 times. We're 100. We're 90
man.
For 102.
People better be scared of y'all.
I'm telling you, man. It's just our guys have really bought into to base running. That's something that we really harp on here,
mm-hmm.
is running the base as well.
Mm-hmm.
And our guys, they do a very good job of reading pitchers. And our guys at the plate have done a very good job too. Now, if our guys, they can catch it out of the corner of the eye. If our guy don't get a good jump,
mm-hmm.
they'll swing and foul it off or swing through it. Try to make that catcher hesitate a little more.
Yeah.
To give our guys time to get there. But if we get a good jump, our guys will take it because that's helping the guy at the plate because
mm-hmm.
he's getting himself in scoring position.
Right. That's right.
He's gonna give me an RBI.
Yeah, that's right.
So it's worked out well.
Yeah.
They've really learned how to work with each other and just hope we can keep rolling.
And again, Coach, you're glad to see so many things fall in place. It's so encouraging to see a team coming together like that.
Yes, sir.
Communicating with each other, learning to play well with each other. That comes with time and good coaching.
It does. And our guys are doing a good job on the mound. I mean, we're throwing strikes and playing good defense. And when you do that, we go out in the field after having a big inning.
Mm-hmm.
We go out there and get them 1, 2, 3. Well, we're about right back in here hitting again.
Yeah.
So it's worked really good of defensively pitching and defense doing a real good job, and that's carrying over into our offense. Our offense is carrying over into our defense. So if we can keep that rolling, man, we're going to be okay.
Okay, so we had Baldwin, and then we moved on into the next week. We were off spring break, and how'd practice go that next week? Tell us about it.
Well, we kicked off at Monday. We went to Jones County.
Yeah.
And they're 5A. I only lost 2 games all year to Houston County.
Yeah.
And we rolled up in there Monday night for their senior night.
Mm-hmm.
And
rained
we
on
beat
their
them,
parade,
we,
didn't
we
you?
Beat them 4-3 in 8 innings.
Yeah.
Case Matthews pitched a phenomenal job.
Mm-hmm.
He pitched 7 innings, got the win, and Jacob Floyd again. Man, he come in, pitched a scoreless 8th, got the save. I mean, his confidence is just climbing, and it's just wonderful to see.
Perfect time of the season.
That's right. That's right.
Mm-hmm.
In that game, I'm trying to think who all did well because we.
Well, you mentioned Case. I mean, he was probably your top
right,
rung
right.
player on that game. You got to give just about the player of the game.
And we
to
made
him
some
on
fantastic
that one.
Plays behind him, defensive wise.
Yeah.
Jared O'Neill, not only is he doing a good job at the plate and stealing bases defensively, man, he is solid at third. I mean, he several balls hit to him hard there, and he took the short hop and threw across the diamond, or threw a dart to second base and get the lead runner. So it was good stuff. I mean, mm-hmm. it really was. Austin Green, sophomore.
Right.
We there in the top of the eighth, and it's 3-3 ball game, and we got a guy on second, called Austin Green to pinch hit. Mm-hmm. He ropes one to right field, base hit, guy scores. Yeah. So he had to go ahead RBI for that game. Mm-hmm. I mean, he's just
patting
his confidence is climbing. I mean, he's batting .500 for us as a pinch hitter.
That's awesome.
Coming off the bench. I mean, you sit over here the whole game and you know,
right.
he stays involved. And it's hard for high school guys to stay that focused and involved what's going on. But I've been very proud of him because he's watching the game. He's paying attention to pitchers. You know, they starting them off with a fastball, first pitch fastball, or they come with a first pitch curve.
Yeah.
So when he got up there, he knew. He knew what this guy was going to do. He's mm-hmm. throwing him away, throwing a little hard. I'm just going to sit back and take what he gives me and not try to do too much.
Mm-hmm.
And he laced one right field.
Yeah.
More in the ball game. So mm-hmm. I've just been, you know, tickled to death with the ways these guys are contributing for this team this year. Let me go back to Baldwin. Nolan Daniel pitched a complete game. I mean, it was a shortened game, five innings.
Yeah.
But in region games, I mean, knock on wood, in region games, Nolan has not given up a run in region games. He's 4-0 in the region. So that's pretty good.
Man, that is good.
That's pretty good. I mean, he's sitting there with a 0.00 ERA in region.
Almost
that's awesome.
Unheard of.
Yep.
Yeah.
So,
and the confidence, like you say, is building in these young people, building in these young men at the right time of the season.
Well, he just keeps pounding that strike zone. I mean, you struck out 32 guys and only walked 9. And then, you know, defense, you got behind you. I mean, that's huge. I was a pitcher. I mean, I know I can step on that mound and I can throw the contact and these guys are going to make the plays behind me, man. That's awesome.
Yeah,
that's good stuff.
It takes a little pressure off of it.
That's right.
Yeah, it takes a little off.
But that Jones County game was huge. It really was. I mean, for them being a 5A school,
sure.
Only lost 2 games all year, and we rolled in there and, you know, beat them 4-3 in extra innings.
Yeah, and it was about the other way around last time, wasn't it?
It was. You know, they beat us here.
School just reversed.
They beat us 7-4 here.
Oh, okay.
But that game, we fell behind some runners, and they're a good ball team. And
when you
got to throw it down the middle, good hitters are going to take advantage of it. And
mm-hmm.
We learned from that, and we knew that going in to Jones. You know, work ahead, stay ahead, make them hit our pitch instead of us having to throw it to them.
Mm-hmm.
And that's what I like to see is our guys learning when we lose and when we make mistakes and making those adjustments. That's just been, you know, phenomenal. I mean,
that's maturity.
Someone asked me the other day, you know, what's the difference in last year's team and this year? Because it was pretty much the same guys. I said, execution. We have executed very well. We've got, I don't know what the school record is in either sack flies or sack bunts this year, but we got to be creeping up on it because this guys are doing a good job. I mean, they're really putting the ball down on, you know, where it needs to be put down and moving guys up. And because our pitching's we had very good pitching last year,
mm-hmm.
and we just didn't swing it as well. But this year, we got better pitching than what we had last year, and we're doing things offensively just very well. So just hope we can keep it rolling.
All right, the last game since we last talked, I guess, was Blakely.
Last night.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Tell us about that.
Blakely County, they're sitting right now second in their region. So, I mean, Blakely's a good ball club. Brad Davis does an excellent job with those guys. And our guys enjoy playing them because they a lot of them play together, you know, during the summer with travel ball and all.
Mm-hmm.
And we played well. We went out there and we ended up winning 10-6 in 8 innings. But our guys battled. Slayton pitched well. Jacob Floyd's on the mound again. Austin Green came in and threw 4 innings, pitched well. And we finally got Caleb Christian back. That was his first appearance
so
in 3
out.
Weeks. So he's got released and he's back healthy. So that's been a huge plus for our pitching staff. Austin Green got his first varsity win last night as a pitcher.
Good.
And Caleb Christian, you know, closed the door in the 8th.
Mm-hmm.
But Jared O'Neill, again, last night, he was 3-4, had 2 doubles, a single, had 4 stolen bases. I mean, that was just I hadn't calculated, but I'd like to see what his batting average is the last, you know, 5-6 games. It's got to be close to 500.
He's coming on up, huh?
He really is. Mm. And the rest of the guys are taking note and, you know, feeding off of him.
Yeah.
I mean, anybody in baseball would tell you, hitting is contagious.
Yeah.
I mean, when a guy goes up there and smokes one, the guy on deck's like, let me do that. Let me go up there and do that too. So that's one thing that's been very nice to see is these guys just loving on each other and playing together.
All right, so now we got everybody healthy. Infield, outfield, everybody's good.
Everybody's healthy. You know, and I just pray that we got four region games left. We got veterans here tomorrow night, if weather holds off. That's huge. We had some help in the region last night, so right now we're in sole possession of second place.
Mm-hmm.
Veterans is first. We win tomorrow night, that'll put us in sole possession of first place. And with three games to go after that one. So,
you know, and looking at it, very winnable game.
Yes, sir.
Compared to when we played them first time. I mean, look at it.
Oh, they are solid, too, now. Veterans has got – they got some good – we are almost carbon copies of each other. Mm-hmm. They got very good arms on the mound. Defensively, they're solid. Mm-hmm. Offensively, you know, you fall behind and you got to throw it down, you know, down the middle. Hitters are going to hurt you.
Yeah.
You know, so it's – tomorrow night it's going to be – who executes and who can capitalize on the other team's, you know, very minimal mistakes that they make. And that's going to be the name of the game. Well, we got to pitch well, we got to play defense, and we got to put the bat on the ball. Mm-hmm. So if we can do that better than veterans, then that'll give us a chance to win.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. All right, so you want to turn out for that game, ladies and gentlemen. That will be a good game.
Yeah, 6 o'clock start. Come on out. That'll be awesome.
All right, then who we got after that? Not looking too far ahead, but just letting people plan.
We go to Howard Friday. You know, Howard upset us here.
Yeah.
You know, first time, so hopefully we can. And our guys have been, they've been looking at that one. They know that we lost that one because of us. So, and we've learned from it, and hopefully we'll correct some mistakes that, you know, that we made the first time with them.
Mm-hmm.
So we got veterans here Thursday. We go to Howard Friday. And then next week is our last two regular season games. Both of them are at home. Tuesday is senior night, April the 19th. Come on out here and support these seniors. They have done a fantastic job with this program of, you know, putting their stamp on it of, you know, what they want to do.
Yeah.
And that's Mary Persons. That's who we'll play next Tuesday. And then we'll finish up the regular season with Upson Lee here on Thursday of next week, April 21st.
And so we'll look at the bracket.
I hope so. I mean, that's we've looked at it. Our four games left. We win all four, we're one seed. We win three out of four, we're two seed. And you don't want to lose two. You don't want to lose two out of four, or three out of four, or four out of four, because that's going to put you
bad.
And you know, seed you don't really want, or you can put you out. I mean, that's how our region rolls. I mean, it's tough.
Yeah, yeah.
We got 5-6 good teams, and two of them's gonna be sitting at home.
Mm-hmm.
So,
but you coming up at the right time. Everybody's what you call peaking at the right time.
That's right.
You got everybody healthy with Christian back, with Caleb back, and so you ought to look real good, Coach.
I hope so. Yeah. We just
time will tell.
God's plan is perfect, and we relied on Him to guide us in the right direction, and we'll just see how it goes.
Yeah, we know you'll do your part.
I'm gonna try.
Yeah. We appreciate what you do, Coach.
I sure. Thank y'all, too. Yeah. Appreciate you.
Asking y'all to turn out now and support West Lawrence Raider baseball. That's coming up Thursday, Friday, and then, you know, next week. So look at the schedule. Turn out. When you see these young men, when you see these coaches out in the community, please encourage them because they need it, and they're doing a great job for our system. We'll see you next time right here.